Sorry about the under construction set. We're kind of working on a new thing. You'll hear up at Salacious Crumbs. We'll have a new set in the next week or two, but in the meantime, I guess you can see my private library. But let's get to what you actually care about. This week on Salacious Crumbs, one casting suspicion dies out while another grows stronger, an update on the Ukrainian presidential election shenanigans, and some interesting news for gamers. Shut up and take my money news. ThinkGeek.com has combined Star Wars with one of my guilty pleasures, kitchen gadgets, to create light-up lightsaber chopsticks. They come in Luke Blue and Vader Red, and, I want them. They're officially licensed by Lucasfilm, batteries are included, and they're only $15 a set. Grab their R2-D2 soy sauce dispenser to match, and you can have a complete Star Wars sushi set. Okay, stop making fun of me. I told you, kitchen gadgets are my weakness. May 14th sees filming for the episode 7 occurring in the Principality of Morocco. Educated guesses point to this being a return to Tatooine, as some of the dual-sunned planet scenes were shot there. Some set pieces still remain in Morocco even to this day. I imagine at this point they'll look pretty much exactly like 30 years have passed with very little doctoring. Adding weight to the Tatooine speculation, The Hollywood Reporter's sources tell them that Episode 7's production budget includes an extensive recreation of Tatooine. And, as a bonus, Morocco is only a short detour away from Tunisia, where most of the original Tatooine scenes were filmed. Tunisia, meanwhile, has launched a Save Mos Espa campaign in order to restore the set of Anakin Skywalker's home, which has been endangered by sand dunes in the desert country. Whether this is an anticipation of filming or just an effort to restore one of their potentially profitable tourism spots is unclear. However, despite rumors to the contrary, it seems that filming has actually already begun. At least in preliminary shooting. In an interview filmed at Loyola Marymount University School of Film and Television, Disney chairman Alan Horn talked a little about Episode 7. He acknowledged that both casting it and the screenwriting process have been difficult. However, although casting is not complete, most of the cast has been decided on, even if it hasn't been announced. For the video, check the links below. Now, I imagine that the Venn diagram of Star Wars fans and Big Bang Theory fans has a definite overlap. For those of you who fall into that category, I've got some exciting news for you. Set your calendars for the May 1st episode. The minds behind the show are planning a huge Star Wars Day celebration episode that will involve a complete recreation of the Dagobah Swamp, with help from Lucasfilm's Industrial Light and Magic. The episode will feature the return of Sheldon's mentor, Professor Proton, played by the amazing Bob Newhart, who will appear to him as a Jedi Master. So be sure to tune in May 1st to kick off your May the 4th Be With You celebrations early. Of course, May the 4th isn't the only day of import in Star Wars fandom. October 11th of this year marks the third annual Star Wars Reads Day. All over the country, libraries and bookstores hold some pretty epic events, so be sure to keep an eye on the official website, starwars.com/reads, and the Facebook page, facebook.com/StarWarsReads, to see what might be happening in your area. There are a ton of Star Wars authors getting in on the action as well, including my favorite mashup author, Ian Dosher, of the fantastic Shakespeare Star Wars series. Seems like we can take Breaking Bad's Jesse Plemons off of the list of rumored cast list for episode 7. Seems he's signed on for Black Mass, a Whitey Bugler biopic starring Johnny Depp. Since Black Mass is slated to start filming in May as well, it seems unlikely that Plemons is on the still super secret cast list. However, while that rumor fades, others grow stronger. Several sites have reported that Peter Mayhew's return as Chewbacca has been confirmed. However, none of these are officially backed up by Lucasfilm or Disney. File this one under probably true, but not verified, okay? Some excellent news for video game fans. It seems that Square Enix will be announcing some information and a release date for Kingdom Hearts 3 at this year's E3. According to PlayStation Universe, there have been some hints from developer Tetsuya Nomura that Star Wars characters might be making an appearance in this one. Can you say lightsaber keyblade? I really hope this rumor's true, you guys. I guess we'll find out at E3. Another small chunk of video game news for you. If any of you were sad about Amy Hennig leaving Naughty Dog and, By extension, her work on the new Uncharted title for the PS4, I have a bit of good news for you. Seems like Hennig has switched over to Visceral Games, where she is the new creative director on the new Star Wars project, bringing some serious sci-fi chops with her. And the video game news just keeps coming. It seems some footage has been released of a cancelled game in which you play Darth Maul. The footage looks pretty cool, so it's a real shame it never came to fruition. To check out what might have been, look for the video in the links below. And remember, for more video game news, be sure to check out The Grid, right here on our channel. Those of you who have already seen the new Captain America probably noted the scene where he has a list of cultural milestones that he missed out on while under ice that he'd like to investigate. On that list, of course, the Star Wars films. Anyone else want to see a short scene featuring the Cap finding out about Luke's parentage for the first time? Come on, Disney, you own the rights to both. You can make this happen. Please, he's like the only adult who doesn't know already. Anyway, an update on last week's report on Darth Vader's run for the Ukrainian presidency. It seems his candidacy has been rejected by the Ukrainian Central Electoral Commission on the grounds that, big surprise, some of his paperwork was forged and/or questionable. Yeah. However, it seems that the man behind the mask, electrician Viktor Shevchenko, actually did change his name to Darth Vader back in March, so that part at least was not forged. Vader was running as a member of the Ukrainian Internet Party established in 2010 by alleged cyber criminal Dmitry Golubov. He had some interesting things to say about their decision to present Darth Vader as their candidate, including that a robot should be in power. Golubov stated that a robot is more decent. It doesn't support corruption. It doesn't corrode. According to all internet polls, Darth Vader leads the pre-election campaign. That's why he's not been registered by the Central Electoral Commission. They are afraid of him. Well, if the guy can't do a basic fact check that Vader is a human with robotic limbs and life support, and therefore a cyborg and not a robot, then it's really no surprise that he didn't get the guy's paperwork in proper order. Come on, Ukraine. You all know how I love to leave you with ridiculous YouTube videos to aid in your procrastination efforts, so today it's a completely fantastic medley of classic rock songs performed by a sci-fi band, all decked out in, you guessed it, Star Wars costumes. Back in Black is as sung by Slave Leia, accompanied by a Darth Vader guitar solo, is pretty fantastic, I have to say. Well, that's it for this week. Be sure to make the most out of your social media by following us on Twitter, Pinterest, Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe to our channel for more of this and our other fantastic shows, and keep up with us for all of your essential sci-fi news, reviews, interviews, and more on sci-fi4me.com. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to spend a few more hours arguing with myself about whether or not I need those lightsaber chopsticks. Okay.